Kevin Spreitzer here. He's Doug Upstone. We are DocSports.com. We're talking some NBA on Friday. It's the Suns and the Nuggets. Phoenix up 2-0 in this series. And now it switches to the Mile High City to Denver for games 3 and 4. The Nuggets, Doug, lay at 1.5, total 223. And Doug, the toughest thing about defending Phoenix, whether you're the Denver Nuggets or anybody else, and we saw, by the way, a perfect example of this in game two, is that they're not just relying on one player to pump in 35, 40 points on a given night in the playoffs. All five starters landed in double figures in points scored the other night. It's tough to make defensive adjustments when everyone on the opposing team is contributing to the cause.
Yeah, that's certainly the case, Scott. And, you know, I, one of the things that, just to throw out there, too, you know, I've had a nice run in the NBA recently and it had a long stretch, and that continues at 58 and 38, a little over 60%. But after a slow start, I think we talked about that a couple of weeks ago in the NBA playoffs on a 10-4 run. So I'm going to try and back it up with some more winners this weekend. And this, you know, this game, to me, it's more about Denver here. And I actually want to read some quotes here about what Mike Malone said after the game two debacle. And, you know, not everybody's going to do this. I know Brad Stevens of Boston wouldn't do this. He didn't mince any words. And I quote, I felt like we quit tonight, which is something we never see. We had no juice, no energy, no passion, no fight, no urgency, no grit. You pick the adjective. It fits. We did not get the job done.
Wow.
Okay. that's a coach laying his team out. But I also think he's setting the table for, you know, to make sure that they are ready to go. And I think there's reason to be hopeful for that, Scott. So now, what is your thoughts on what could happen?
Well, Will Barton, by the way, as far as coaches doing that stuff, it didn't work well for the Boston Bruins the other night, I'll tell you that much. And
no.
And I don't know if he was describing his own team or the LA Lakers once AD got hurt. So there you go. But, you know, Will Barton played in his first game since April 23rd, I believe it was. So the rust has been shaken off, so to speak. He adds to this team's depth, obviously. And maybe Monte Morris can feel more comfortable at home after going 2-for-17 through the first two games. In fact, Doug, I was looking at the numbers, and Morris and Porter are a combined 11 of 43, 26% shooting so far in this series. They aren't going to make a dent at all against Phoenix if that keeps up. So obviously these two players have got to start shooting the ball better. I was looking at this from a total perspective. You know, we talked about the other game on Friday slate in another video. Folks can check that out. But I look towards unders in game three of playoff series first. And more often than not, if I do play a total in game three of a series, I do play the under. However, there is that rare occasion when I look to play a high. And the Suns only drop off 3 points per game on the road as opposed to home court scoring. Morris and Porter have been a disaster on the road. I just mentioned 11 of 43 combined. I would think they shoot a little bit better at home. Everyone on the Nuggets has to feel more comfortable on the offensive end at home than they did on the road. This is one of those rare times in a game three, Doug, where the over looks decent to me. And again, it's sitting right around 223.
Yeah, you know what, Scott? I can't disagree with you on that at all. I think, you know, I think you're on the right track there, certainly on that. And, you know, I'm looking at the side, though, and I think that Denver, you know, the modern athlete, the one thing that he absolutely hates is to be disrespected. Okay. I mean, above and beyond anything else, they hate that. And their coach just disrespected them. Okay. So every one of those players, he literally held accountable, including himself. I mean, Malone sure. Included. He used I quite a bit in his press conference. And so I think they're going to be ready to go. And I think the adjustment that they're going to make is, you know, Barton's going to a big factor to come back. But I think the adjustment they're going to make is they're going to look to get Porter and Gordon going towards the basket more, as opposed to just either being jump shooters or just, in some cases, ignoring Aaron Gordon. And they did that in game three against Portland. So, you know, and I think that was really the big key for them that set the tone for that series is they got those guys going to the basket, and then Jokic, then it opened up for him. Now, if Barton is a legitimate shooter than from the outside. There's their number three scorer, but legitimate shooter. That opens up the whole floor for them, you know. And as you mentioned about, you know, Phoenix having five scorers in double digits. Well, sure. I think that's kind of probably the same goal for Denver here. And the 1.5, even though it looks brutal to do it based on the, you know, the last two games, I'm inclined to go with Denver here and to give the points.
Sounds good, Doug. Looking at laying it with Denver, and I'm looking at over 223 on this particular video. Wanted to mention, folks, about that $60 free account that you see on your screen. Right below the video, you can click on a link where you can set yourself up for a free $60 account. You can use that if you're not yet a member at DocSports.com on any of Doug's daily packages, any of mine, anybody else on the roster at DocSports.com. Doug just mentioned how well he's been doing in the NBA for quite a while now. We're just having a real nice run over $5,000 regular season run in baseball, about $5,000 in the WNBA, soccer about $5,000 ahead since February 1st. It's been outstanding. Oh, and NASCAR. I wanted to mention NASCAR because we hit the 4-star last week, the 7-star the week before that. Don't forget about NASCAR, folks. 58-32 is my NASCAR record going back to May of 2019. All of those plays at DocSports.com. And we'll look to rack it up and do it again here this weekend in the All-Star race. So be sure to check all of that out. But again, a few people over at DocSports.com doing well right now. So check them all out with that free $60 account if you're not yet a member. He's Mr. Upstone. I'm Scott. Let's put him in the win column. We are DocSports.com.